Good morning, children. I wish all of you are in good health and taking all the safety measures. Children, we should welcome each day with a smile, a spirit of giving, a sense of humanity, a pledge to spread peace and happiness. Here, your computer teacher welcomes you in the class. So class 1, let's start our chapter 4, Working with Computer. Children, as we know, computer is an electronic device. It needs electricity to work. So first, we need to switch on the computer. Children, to switch on the computer, first we have to switch on this button to switch on the CPU. Now we need to press this button on the bottom right corner to switch on the monitor. In a case computer asks you the password, you can enter the valid password. Children, after doing this, we will be able to see a screen. This screen is called desktop. And now we can work on computer. As we all know, computer is a dumb machine. It cannot do anything on its own. It always needs instructions to work. So children, what do we need to instruct computer? Yes, we need input devices. So children, now we will study about mouse and its function. Children, as we have already studied about mouse is an input device with two buttons and a scroll wheel. The button on the left hand side is called left mouse button, and the button on the right side is called right mouse button. And the scroll wheel is in between left and right mouse button to move back and forth. Children, as we know, mouse is called a pointing and selecting device. So when this mouse is connected to the computer, we can see an arrow. This arrow-like figure is called pointer. This pointer moves according to the movement of mouse on mouse pad. It means when we move our mouse in forward direction, pointer will also move forward. And when we move it back, cursor will also move back. Yes, children, we can see this moving pointer on the screen. It is moving according to the movement of mouse on mouse pad. Now, we are going to understand the different method of working with mouse. The first method of using mouse is clicking. Clicking left button of the mouse once is called clicking the mouse. It is used to point and select desired option. Children, you can understand it in a better way with this example. Okay children, look at this multiple choice question. What is your favorite fruit? Your answer can be any. Apple, banana, grapes, mango or orange. So, to choose the right answer, you have to click on the desired option, as I have done by clicking on grapes. You can see how we can click mouse to select the desired option. Next method of using mouse is double clicking. In this way, we have to press the left mouse button twice, one after another. It means we have to press the left mouse button two times. children, double clicking is used to run the selected program or to open any program. Yes, you can see how quickly we have to press the left mouse button. Next method is right clicking. Pressing the right mouse button once is called right clicking the mouse. By right clicking, we can see a shortcut menu displayed on the screen. Children, you can see we have to press right mouse button in this way. Now, the next method is dragging the mouse. Moving the mouse with its left button pressed is called dragging. Children, we are doing two tasks at once. One, pressing left mouse button, and second, dragging the mouse, and both have to be done together. It is used for moving the object from one place to another. Now children, you can see how we have to move the mouse from one place to another with the left mouse button pressed. Now, the next method of using mouse is dropping. Releasing the left mouse button after dragging is called dropping. Children, whatever we have dragged is to be dropped, and this can be done with dropping method. This way, we can change the location of any object. Releasing the mouse button can be seen with this example. See how drag and drop work together on the screen. Children, let's understand it with the object at P1 location, which we have to move to P2 location. To move object from P1 location to P2 location, we will press left mouse button, then hold it and move it to P2 location, and then we will release the mouse pointer. This way we can move any object from one location to another location. Now children, we are going to study the last method of using mouse, that is scrolling. Moving the mouse wheel forward or backward using finger is called scrolling. See children, sometimes what happens? We cannot see all the content on the screen at once. So, we have to move the page up and down so that we can see the entire content. See, the scrolling is done to move page up and down. Thank you. Have a great scholastic day.